Right, we're recording. Okay, so here I am about to clean up this picture. Hopefully this setup's going to work. Let's have a little rub, see what comes up naturally. Oh, it's coming up quite well. You see, I've done all the painting, and this is where we have the final reveal. Now, I'm just removing a bit of salt there, which can get in the way. And we'll see what happens when we clean up here. Now, I try and use my fingers as much as possible because it's quite satisfying and works quite well. But you'll see after a while, some bits don't work quite so well. So that's when I have to use other devices and tools. Now, I'll get a moment. The reason this is not coming up is the salt has formed a layer, which is causing it after actually getting out of the masking fluid to clean it up. But there we are. It's going. This one's cleaning up really quickly. Now what I will do is I use a putty rubber. I've got a putty rubber, and that often works where, as you see, it just helps pick up the masking fluid. Now it's dried on, and helps you clean up. Has a double advantage of getting rid of all those annoying pencil lines. Although surprisingly most of them do come off with as I say, they do come off with the masking fluid, so I don't normally have too many pencil lines left at the end of it. I tend to feel around because you can normally tell by just feel where the masking fluid hasn't come up. You just pick it up. It's doing really well. Most of it seems to have come off now. Just do a few areas where I know there's a little bit more. Now, the trouble with this is I often forget where I've put it by the time I finish the painting. And it's not unknown for me to discover little bits of masking fluid at a later date. Most of it seems to be coming off nicely, so I don't think it's going to be too much of a problem this time. Now there are a few stubborn areas, so I'm going to move on to a different tool. This is slightly different to the one I used last time. It's another scraper foil tool. Not my favourite, but my favourite seems to have gone walkies at the moment, so I'm using this one, which is a bit like a scalpel, but it's not as sharp. You see, I can put my finger on there without cutting myself. And it's important it's not too sharp, because if it's too sharp, it tends to scratch the paper, whereas this just stays above it, doesn't gouge in and cause a mess. Now, part of this point is, part of the way to do this is figuring out where you think you put your masking through, which is easier said than done. You see, there's bits here, like when I've used the acrylic ink, and it's formed quite a thick layer, so I need to work in a bit more to get rid of that. But I think this is going well. Yeah. I will basically dig in to the paint and hopefully get down to the masking layer underneath. And usually it works quite well. Every now and then there's a little bit of a tear, but it seems to be behaving this time. Yeah, before I started recording, it was really quiet. And now the world is white font to drive past, so I apologise for the cars going past at the regular intervals. It's not normally this busy. Right. Now there's some lettering there. That's the manufacturer of the engine, which was Crossley Brothers. It's a sail mill. Personal collection to them. I'll explain that in the notes with this, won't I? Let's clean that up a bit. And a little bit over here. Clean up really well. Some days they come off really nicely, and other days she seems to be going on for hours with very little progress. But this one seems to be a good one, which is always a relief. Okay. I think I'm going to stop there because I don't think I'm going to do much quickly. So there I am, more or less completed. I will post the finished close up once I've finished the final nitty little bits. And there we go.